Hi, this is Elizabeth, one of the co-hosts of Beauties and Headcanons. Thanks for listening to the following broadcast on Public House Media.
This is Bryce Burge, host of Your Soccer Passport here on Public House Media. After this episode, come join us on a trip around the soccer world as we discuss club and country every Tuesday. Stamp Your Soccer Passport by subscribing on Spotify, iTunes, or wherever you get your Public House Media podcasts. And thanks again for checking out the following broadcast on Public House Media.
Coffee with Keith
and Katie on Public House Media,
and we are thrilled to be coming at you again from our Chicago Northside apartment. Katie has her coffee with her.
I do
not have my coffee with me yet, because today's show I will be taking part in yet another food test. We've been on the food testing kick for quite a bit, no, quite a while now. We did the...
Well, it seems like you guys really love the food, the contests and the taste test. That seems to be your thing.
Right.
And we aim to please.
Yeah. So...
So, more.
Yeah, absolutely. We did mac and cheese a while back. Katie didn't do well on that. She always preferred Kraft, but she actually went with another one with the blind taste test.
No, that was... That was... We have to redo the mac and cheese one. There was something wrong with it. We agreed afterwards.
We agreed after we tried it, there was something wrong with it. However, for leftovers, when you were not comparing the Kraft to anything else, you said that the leftover Kraft mac and cheese tasted just fine.
Yep. And then I made another box of Kraft cheese, and it was amazing.
Right. So just... Funny that the Kraft did not taste good while comparing it to other mac and cheese.
We're off topic, Keith.
So we did mac and cheese. We did beer taste testing.
Which
I did well.
Compared light beer to regular?
It was a little...
Normal?
It wasn't quite right. It was supposed to be Miller Lite, Coors Light, and Budweiser. Bud Light. I communicated. There was a failure on the execution part. Katie didn't pick up the right kind of beer, so I did the beer taste test. I did great at it. I got 3 out of 3, but it was, you know, comparing light beer to Budweiser and, you know, Pabst Blue Ribbon. So we're going to have to do another one later on where I'm actually doing... comparing light beer to light beer and seeing if I can tell the difference.
You always get High Life, which is not a light beer.
I always do.
Which is why I didn't get light.
We discussed it that day. Anyways, I went shopping today and I picked up the right kind of stuff. So, getting to why I don't have coffee is that we are going to be doing coffee taste testing when we come back after the break. It'll only be me, because Katie usually does not like just normally brewed coffee. However, I only drink black coffee, unless it's some sort of, you know, fancy drink that Starbucks has that I take part in every once in a while. I usually only drink black coffee. I don't put in creamer, I don't put in sugar, I don't put in milk, because I drink enough coffee where if I decorated it up with cream and sugar, I would get diabetes. So, I only do black coffee. So, what we have and what we will be doing, excuse me, Mr. Fuzzy Face, and what we will be doing when we get back is we will be comparing and doing a blind taste test. See if I can tell the difference between Pike Place coffee, the original coffee for Starbucks, the original blend of Dunkin' Donuts, and the original premium roast McCafe coffee. Now, disclaimer, which I will quickly review when we get back from the break as well. All of them are medium roast. Medium medium, mm-hmm. and medium roast. All medium roasts, all considered the each company's original roast. Each original, each medium. They will all be prepared the same way, pour over method, and Katie will be conducting the test when we get back, and I will be seeing if I can tell the difference between Pike Place from Starbucks, Dunkin' Donuts original, and McCafe's original. That all is coming up.
Coming up.
On.
Stay tuned. Don't change that channel.
On Public House Media, Coffee with Keith and Katie. Don't go away. We're coming right back to see how I do. Welcome back, everybody.
Hey, guys.
So we just prepared the coffee. Again, they were all lined up. They are in equal cups.
Yes, the same cup, so he can't tell by the shape of the handle or the thickness.
Every cup is labeled, so they cannot be misplaced. Mm-hmm. And I will have my eyes closed during it. Again, they were all prepared the same way with the pour-over technique. They were all prepared 6 ounces of coffee in the cup. I'm obviously not going to drink all 6 ounces, but we measured each cup based on what each package suggested for 6 ounces. It's usually 1 tablespoon equals 6 ounces. That's usually what they say. So, without further ado, I will close my eyes.
Yep.
And Katie will give me whatever cup of coffee she wants to, and I will taste each one, and then I will tell her what I think after I taste it. So, right now, closing my eyes on the honor system.
Yep.
Eyes are closed. I can feel you. You almost hit me.
I would never hit you on purpose. You ready?
Yeah. Oh, we should get some water for me.
Oh. Okay.
To cleanse the palate.
Alright. Hold on.
Alright, ready to go.
Ready?
Ready.
Alright, close your eyes.
Eyes are closed.
Alright. Cup number one. It's very hot. Got it?
Got it.
We got these mugs as part of our wedding dish set. So, good news. They've lasted 7.5 years. I'm not sure we've ever used them before today, though, but they've lasted. The little sticker. Choice number two.
Okay.
Okay. See how you do. Then one.
Hey, what are you doing?
What?
What are you saying?
I'm talking to the camera.
Are you joking with me?
No.
You have to do this the right way.
I am doing it the right way.
Okay.
All right. You ready?
Ready.
All right.
Can I open my eyes?
No, not yet.
Oh, okay.
What was the first one?
Duncan?
Nope.
No?
Nope.
I would say McDonald's.
Yes.
Okay.
All right, what was the second one?
The second one was Starbucks.
Nope.
No.
Mm-mm.
Middle one was Dunkin'.
Yes.
Last one was Starbucks.
Was it?
I don't think you gave me Starbucks once, to be honest with you. Can I open my eyes?
Yeah.
I don't think you gave me Starbucks. Did you?
Nope.
I knew you didn't give me Starbucks. I knew you didn't give me
Starbucks. Could you tell it was the same one?
The first one and the second, the first one and the last one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You didn't show it, though.
I said you had to do it for real. What's the point of doing this if you're not going to do it the right way? I knew you didn't give me Starbucks.
Okay, close your eyes again.
Close my eyes again?
Yeah.
Well, why? What's the point?
We'll do two more.
I can't even trust that you're going to do this correctly.
I am holding up the sticker so you know it's true.
I don't know nothing's true because I don't know nothing. I don't know anything's true because I have my eyes closed.
Close your eyes.
I knew you didn't give me Starbucks. Neither one of those tasted like Starbucks.
And yet you said that the second one was Starbucks.
All right, so the first one was McDonald's.
Yes.
And the second one was Dunkin'.
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
All right. Which was which?
The second one was Starbucks.
Yes. Could you actually...
The first one was Dunkin'.
Yes.
Yeah.
Could you actually taste the difference?
Yes.
Between all three of them?
A lot of it has to deal with the smell.
Yeah?
The smell with coffee is so important. I knew you didn't give me Starbucks because I couldn't smell it. I think Starbucks Pike Place has a distinct smell. So... how would I do? I don't know. I know what Starbucks tastes. Now, for me, it doesn't... I've never sworn by one or the other. I've obviously drank a lot more Starbucks. When I started drinking a lot of coffee in college, Starbucks was on campus. There was actually a Starbucks closer to campus, a real Starbucks, than there was like a Dunkin' Donuts or even a McDonald's, really. There wasn't a McDonald's really near campus.
It was right across the street from Starbucks.
Right. So they were both the same spot. So, but I've always said in person, going to McDonald's, drinking a brew in McDonald's, and I always actually thought McDonald's did a pretty decent cup of coffee for being a dollar. So I never swore by Starbucks over any other one. I've obviously consumed a lot more Starbucks than any other, just simply because of proximity. Definitely in Chicago, there's literally one on every corner. Even more so than Dunkin', and there are a lot of Dunkins around here too.
Mm-hmm.
But they're all fine. I think the first one I said was Dunkin', right?
Yes.
See, I actually. In the what I preferred, I knew you didn't give me Starbucks. I can say that truthfully. I knew you didn't give me Starbucks because I couldn't smell it.
Then you shouldn't have said Starbucks at any point. You should have been able to say. We have to liven it up a little.
But the validity of...
Is this show about customer reviews and validity, or is it entertainment?
Well, it's about entertainment. I was not very entertained by that stunt that you just pulled.
I was. Vote. Comment below. Was that entertaining? Would you rather just hear Keith ramble on about coffee?
Well, when you put it that way, my goodness. See, I have absolutely no issues now with giving Katie all that garbage about her not knowing what kind of peanut butter she likes, or mac and cheese she likes. What else do you swear by?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
There are a couple of other things that Katie prefers. But we'll find something else to ruin Katie's evening on eventually.
I think my evening has been ruined enough. Several times.
But this is the second time Katie has cheated.
The second time, and I have been humiliated countless times.
We have nothing in this relationship if we don't have trust, Katie. And when it comes to you serving me coffee, I don't know if I can trust you anymore.
I thought we were playing a game. The Fez and I will just pack our bags and leave.
Okay. I keep the coffee.
I take Mr. Fuzzy Face.
You can have him. Yeah, that's right. He just looked up like, huh? Anyways.
We've rambled. It ran away with us.
This has been Coffee with Keith.
And Katie on Public House Media.
Maybe in the future we'll do some different coffees and we'll see if I can do a eyes open taste test. See if I can tell the difference then.
See if I can behave myself.
It's the only way I can ever trust Katie again.
I'm sneaky. She's sneaky.
You don't have to be sneaky to fool someone with your eyes there with their eyes closed. You just have to be dishonest.
But I am sneaky.
If now I'll give you this. If my eyes were open and if I would have been looking at the cups, and if you still would have given me two McDonald's and a Dunkin', then I really would have been impressed.
I had to be careful because you drank so much. I had to be careful on the how it felt.
And how heavy it was.
You drank too much. Anyway.
Well.
Let's let these people enjoy their Sunday.
All right. You'll probably enjoy it more than I will now.
He's going to throw a little tantrum. Throw footballs on, no, so it's okay. No. He'll get over it.
Take care. Everybody, have a great week. And we will see you next week for more Coffee with Keith.
And Katie.
Take care, and we will see you.